hard dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 103 in our series, Create a RubyGem, Nerd Dice. And in our previous episode, we did our kind of preparation for releasing a patch version with the exception of the gem signing certificate. So we're going to do that part in this video and then hopefully release a patch version 0.5.1 of our gem and then merge our main pull request into the master branch. And then in the master branch, we'll also do some additional changes to our update our change log, get the checksums in there, and then update our security.md here. So we noted here in our security policy that versions 0.4 and down are deprecated with an end of life of 2024/2023. Today is 2024/2024, so I can mark those as end of life rather than just deprecated. So, and then we'll update, 0.5.x will still be current. It'll just be 0.5.1 instead of 0.5.0. So we'll go in and, thankfully I have in my previous commit message, the instructions for doing this pretty well, documented here. So we're going to go into, let me just make sure my SSH directory is okay to display. I think we're good. So we've got our gem private key, our gem public key. We're going to go into we'll make directory 2023.02 and then move those there. Now those are gone, so we need to now do a gem cert, remove certs. Build it, pause here. All right, so I entered the passphrase for the private key. And if we look here, now we're back and we've got a gem public key and a gem private, a public cert and gem private key. The next step that we do here is we copy need to get back to the see that our cert has changed. We need to trust the new cert. do a gem build, even though this isn't the actual version we'll release and push. Let's do that to try it out. This will show as 0.6.0, but we're not actually going to do that. So when we do this gem build, we'll do it from the branch, the 5.x stable branch. So let's see here. You've specified the URI, where the following keys, homepage URI, source code URI, only the first one will be shown on RubyGems. All right, so enter my passphrase. And that worked. Now, the next step is to gem install with high security. That succeeded. Gem uninstall. All right, so that successfully uninstalled. So I think we can essentially use this as our basis, git status, git rm, that. Sign it. And I've got to unindent everything. I'll adapt this slightly. I'll pause for a moment. All right, so instead of just repasting this, the process here, I just reference the commit where the detailed process is found, noted when the certificate will expire, and then we'll close this. Let's make sure that everything else is closed. Like it is. And we'll get a push here. Now to... Do I have that? I don't have that shortcut done. Okay. So we're going to now, while the other one is building, git switch 05x stable. Make sure our version here is 0.5.1. Now we want to cherry pick those two commits from the other branch here, and that build passed. So we'll get cherry pick both modified cherry. Just do usually the signing doesn't work here, so we're going to do a git commit end no edit. Alright, so we've got that going. Now we want to cherry pick the other commit. To the 0.5 branch, make sure the build passes. It does not. All jobs failed. Set up Ruby. Oh, it's because, yeah. So let's thank you. cherry pick again. Look at this gemfile.lock. Yeah, and this is the issue here. So we need to just do a little bit of manipulation here. Sure, we can do a bundle install. That worked. Okay. So do essentially the cherry pick continue. Edit. And cherry pick the second commit. Force push to the branch. And see if we now successfully build. That build now succeeded. We will get that build command. All right, I need to enter my RubyGems code here. By the time you watch this video, it will have long since expired. Successfully registered the gem. Now we go and look at rubygems.org. Nerd. Dice 0.5.1 is the latest. And good to go here. So the other thing I'll do is from RubyGems with high security, and it works. All right, let's get back to our feature branch here. While we're on 0.5 stable, we will bump the working version to 0.5.2. So that next year we don't have to do this, or next time something comes up we don't have to do this. And I need to also do this in the gemfile.lock. That's working. There we go. Sure if that build passes. Get switch to our new branch, back to our feature branch. And so far we have our issue. So done, 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 done. And now we need to update our change log, our security policy, and our checksums. So we'll go to the VS Code here. So security, we'll deal with the changelog first. So we need a I guess it was technically after midnight. What did it say here? It uses GMT anyway. That's why I had my certificate expired for a day, because I did it after GMT and I thought it was the 24th, not the 23rd US Eastern time. We'll say 24th here. Executive decision. So I'll pause and write out my expected my changes to the changelog. We'll review them in a moment. All right, so I've got my changelog updates here. So this is essentially what we put in the commit message for the two commits that we did here. I did change one item in the I need to change it everywhere on the 223 2024 ones or the 2.1.2. All right, so I think our change log is done, and then our security MD here. And let me go back to GitHub. Security policy. I think I can do this in the editor here. So I'll change this and preview it and then see how it looks. So what I'm going to do, deprecated stuff, move to end of life, change the warning icon to like some sort of an X or something. And then change the first part here where it talks about the future kind of will not receive initial updates. That just change the language to indicate that this is in the past now. Be right back. All right, and so this is the previewed version, so everything else is marked as end of life. Got that back into the editor. So we'll make a commit with the changes to the changelog and security policy. Full commit message here. I'll pause and write my commit message. All right, we've got our commit message here. Git push. Take a look at our issues, and we need to generate checksums and commit back to master. So I deleted the gem. So we can get this back by going to rubygems.org, going to download here, and it should Hopefully that. No such file or directory. Oh, it needs to be in package. So we've got new checksum files. /256. E78C. E78C. Right, commit those, and this I think will complete the issue. Oh, I need to tag the release as well, but we'll do this first. Write this commit message, and then we also need to check out and tag that other version to get everything squared away. Pause and write my commit message. All right, I've got my commit message here. This I think will complete the GitHub issue, so we'll be able to create a pull request off of that. Git push here. And then we need to check out the second to last commit. Here that we built off of. We're going to git switch here. We're in a, I have to actually use checkout. Detached head state. So from that detached head state, I want to create a git tag. So we're going to do git tag dash a v 0.5.1 dash dash sign. Git push dash dash tags. We should have a new tag available to us. We'll also now check our GitHub action, which just still... Okay, the checksums one succeeded. And then the tag push is now building in GitHub Actions. So, should be able to now go here. I'm gonna open a pull request into master. Of just mostly have the issue here. It's kind of a combination of this. Create that pull request. Those are the four that we're looking for here. So our tag passed here. We'll wait for that build to complete before merging the pull request. So now we can go into our tags here. Tags. Create release. Set as the latest release is correct. I'm gonna just yoink the change log. Publish that release. Get our action, which is now passed. We'll merge the pull request from the command line. Git checkout master. Only our branch git push. Close closes our pull request. In our project. Good to go. We'll just get rid of the stale branch here. Rid of the branch, and I think we are good to go. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching this stateless code video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. Check out our growing library of videos on our social media channels. Follow us at Stateless Code, and taxation is theft.